bad lip reading to follow. Yeah, this lovely trip of ours, we thought we were getting a new canoe with a new spray deck to keep out rainwater and when running rapids. We decided to put it off for a year. It would have been lovely to have this year, but that's the way it goes. So I'll just sit in the rain and bail out the canoe. There are many lovely sights on Brabant Lake, some right next to the water, others up high, so you get a great view of the lake. You just have to be careful getting out your tent late at night. That first step can be a doozy. There's another one of those great sights on Brabant Lake right next to the water here. You can put in a plethora of tents. Now, that is massive, huge, wide open. Those great views from every side. Just wonderful. One of the things we always pack with us is our protein up wraps. They are spectacular. You can crush them up, roll them up, throw them in a barrel, and they're great for weeks. Highly recommend them. One problem you can have on big giant lakes like Brabant is that you become windbound. And that's what has happened to us. But fortunately for us, we've come across some family's camp. And they've done a simply remarkable job of creating a beautiful camp. They've cleared it out. It's huge, expansive, wide open, water on three sides. It is simply incredible. We are very fortunate to find it here on this very terrible day. Looks like we might have to spend the day here, but hey, there's a lot worse spots than this out here in northern Saskatchewan. So whoever's family this belongs to, thank you so much. One of our many toys is the no bug zone. It does just that, keeps the bugs out, keeps them at bay. A very wonderful piece of equipment to have if you want to carry a little extra weight. It does take a little getting used to setting up, but it's well worth its days. Not all sites are huge and expansive. Some are quite tight and give you enough room to put up your tent and your tarp, and that's about it, but that's okay. Good campsites are found, not made. There are many opportunities on this trip to do some boulder scrambling. Lots of places to get out of your canoe and go exploring, poking around to see what you can find. And maybe perhaps a pictograph that is yet to be found. At least that was our hope, but we didn't find anything, but it was a great time to get out of the canoe and look around and see what we could find. just in case you thought it had stopped raining at some point along our trip. It never stopped raining. We got rain every day. Sometimes in the morning, sometimes in the evening, sometimes at night. It just didn't stop. I usually don't film portage trails because they're usually just portage trails. But when they're terrible and awful, you gotta at least put a few images in. Yes, this is a portage trail with that stream running right through it. Right through it. You're gonna wade through that. And then you're gonna wade across this where you're gonna sink up to your knee every second step. It's truly terrible. And then you get the next part of the portage trail where it's just water and muck and disgusting mess. So you gotta figure things out as you go along. You gotta think outside the box. So what do you do when you get a light fiberglass canoe? Well, you just drag it because you're not gonna hurt it. There's so much water and grass, and you just pull it along very easily with hardly a care in the world. So this is the aftermath of those terrible portages. Our clothes are mucky and wet, but fortunately we have a nice end of the day to at least try and dry them out before we pack them back up. Not enough time to wash them today. Northern Saskatchewan is truly beautiful. Many beautiful sights and sounds. I highly recommend a trip from Brabant back to Missinipe.